Good morning, my colleagues, members of the media, fellow countrymen and women. You do recall that yesterday I addressed the nation pertaining to the plight of our colleague, Honorable J.J. Banda, Independent Member of Parliament for Petauke Central. And I did mention to the nation that we shall do everything possible to ensure that our colleague, the Independent Member of Parliament for Petauke Central, is found and he be with the family and his electorate. I'm glad to inform the nation that Honorable J.J. Banda is safe and is alive. He is currently at Maina, Soko Military Hospital undergoing medical checkups. I want to inform the nation that it is important that our colleague is in a safe environment until we thoroughly investigate the matter. We need to protect him. We don't know who was responsible for the abduction. I would like to assure the family that we will do everything possible to ensure that the perpetrators of this heinous crime are brought to book. It is in the interest of the family and the nation to know who is behind this criminal activity. I would like to request the family to cooperate with us as we endeavor to find the perpetrators of this crime. It is in their interest to ensure that their brother, uncle, is in a safe environment. Maina Soko Military Hospital is a safe and secure environment. Our brother, J.J. Banda, is not the first one to be in Maina Soko Hospital. The officers there, the doctors there, and the medical personnel are professional individuals. Members of the public may recall that our colleague, Honorable Chishimba Kambwili, when he was brought back from Zimbabwe, he was taken to Maina Soko Military Hospital, and he was treated well. He's now back at home. In the same vein, we'd like to appeal to the public not to be misled by malicious reports that are being circulated. There is no harm that is going to occur to our colleague. I also wish to reiterate what I had said yesterday, that it is not in the interest of anyone to make insinuations, allegations against government pertaining to this matter. True to my assurance, we have worked throughout the night to ensure that our colleague is safe. And I can assure the nation that he's safe. We will thoroughly investigate the matter, and the nation will be informed of the outcome. We have nothing to hide whatsoever in this matter. It is in our interest to ensure that the truth is brought to the attention of members of the public. I would like to appeal to members of the public not to be swayed by any politician to do anything that is inimical to the interest of the people of Zambia. Let's work together in peace. Let's not allow people to start making hate speeches, tribal remarks arising from this particular issue. I also want to remind Zambians that one of the leaders of the UKA Alliance in 2004, when he was one of the vice presidents of the UPND, he was abducted together with his children. We did not make any allegations against government then. We allowed the due process of the law to take place. We allowed the police to investigate the matters thoroughly. It is the same police who are in place currently, who are doing the investigations. We have a lot of confidence in the police. I have no doubt in my mind that they will do a thorough job. And I can assure the nation that those who are responsible will be held accountable. That is an assurance I'm making to the nation. To the family, I know how you are feeling. It's a very emotive matter, but please bear with us. We are with you. We assist you to ensure that this matter is settled in your interest and in the interest of the nation. Thank you, fellow countrymen and women.
Thank you very much.
If there are any questions, I'm available.
That yes. was addressed by the yes. minister. Please, questions. We'll start with Sharon. Specifically yes. with regard to the subject of the matter.
Yes.
Good morning, Minister. My name is Sharon from Times of Zambia.
Yes, madam.
You haven't mentioned where he was found and who found him.
He was found in Kafue by Zambia police, working together with members of the public, arising from the plea which I had made yesterday.
What is his condition at the moment? Is he able to speak? Is it critical? Is it stable? What do you know?
As far as I'm concerned, my colleague, Honorable JJ Banda, is very stable. He's very able to speak. He has been in having discussions with the police. He's very stable. There's nothing serious physical which is visible on his body.
Are you also able to talk about the commotion that we hear? There was a scuffle between the family and the police at the first health facility that he was taken before he was moved to Maina, Soko. Are you able to speak to that?
I will not be in a position to talk about what really transpired there. But what I can say is that it is in the interest of the nation and himself and the family that is taken to a very safe environment. We don't know who is behind the abduction of JJ Banda. And we cannot guarantee safety at a private institution like Medland Hospital. I cannot guarantee that. But at Maina Soko Military Hospital, security is guaranteed for himself and any other person who's interested in this matter.
Members of Parliament also held a press briefing yesterday where they insisted that government is involved, and even after your press briefing yesterday, where some very strong sentiments were made, what would you say to that in the face of the latest on this issue?
It is very unfortunate, and I did make a plea yesterday that all of us as leaders, we must always be collected in the submissions we make to the public. You recall I made an assurance that we shall do everything possible to bring back our colleague. And I will still repeat that it is irresponsible, malicious, and mischievous to make utterances like the ones that are being made by my colleagues, members of parliament, who are leaders. They are making very divisive statements without any basis whatsoever. Zambia is a united nation from the time of independence, even before. We live as one people. And I would appeal that all of us leaders must measure our statements for the sake of unity of this country. You cannot start making allegations, make hate speech, tribal remarks out of this unfortunate incident. Now that we have found our colleague, what are they going to say? Let us wait for facts to come out. Our colleague is alive. He's alive and he will be able to tell his story. And ourselves as government, we are going to thoroughly investigate this matter. Will not leave any stone unturned. It is our duty and responsibility to thoroughly investigate this matter. It appears there is something more. That something more will be found after we have thoroughly investigated this matter. That's what I can say. But I will appeal to leaders of political parties and so on, and others, please, let's not continue making inflammatory statements. Yes, sir.
My name is Nchim Nyangandu from Diamond TV.
Yes.
Honorable Minister, we did see the arrest of Mr. Munia Zulu just right outside Maina Soko Military Hospital. What would you say on that?
I want to state that it is irresponsible on the part of Mr. Munia Zulu to behave the way he has been behaving. In this country, there are laws that are applicable. And as a leader, he should behave as a leader. He's a leader. Whether he's, you know, an independent member of parliament, he's a leader in this country. And every Zambian look forward to him. He should lead by example. Not always finding himself on the other side of the law. It is not correct. His behavior is unbecoming. You recall the statements he has been making, where he has been calling for Eastern Province to be on their own. People from Southern Province should not be allowed to be in Eastern Province. Northern Province, you know, if they want, they can be on their own. What sort of a leader is that? Who can be making such statements? This country is resided by so many people. Any Zambian or other nationalities are free to reside anywhere in this country. Now, if we are going to be making statements which are targeting people who are residing in certain areas who don't hail from there, it's very unfortunate. This is what led to problems in Rwanda. This is what is leading to xenophobia activities in South Africa, which we should not allow in this country. Such leaders should be held accountable. I appeal to Zambians not to listen to such leaders. We have been living in this country as one people. We never look at tribe. You go to Kasama, you find Tongas there. They have considered that as home. You go to Monze, there are Bembas there. There are even Bemba headmen, for those who don't know, in Monze. There are headmen from Eastern Province in Southern Province. It is our culture of living together. And currently, a lot of people have intermarried. What happens if you start, you know, driving this tribal issue, driving hate speeches against one tribe, wanting to divide this country? It is unacceptable. Such people must be held responsible, and they must be held accountable. When the long arm of the law follows them, members of the public should not cry foul. I call upon the church, the traditional leaders, to counsel people who are driving this narrative. This matter, as I indicated, will be resolved in the interest of the country.
There are some people that feel that, you know, what has happened, I don't know if you could call it an abduction to a person at the level of a member of parliament, you know, spells, you know, fears of unsafety in the country. What would you say to that? What's the situation?
I can safely say that the country is relatively safe compared to other countries. And I gave you an example of Honorable Sakwiva's Kota. He was an MP that time and a vice president of the UPND when he was abducted. And we didn't drive a political or tribal narrative when he was abducted. No, not at all. Because we are responsible people. We believe in the rule of law. I've made an assurance to those people who are making those, you know, comments. Please be assured that we will ensure that every Zambian is safe. I would like to call upon Zambians to report any suspicious activities to the police or any law enforcement agency. That is a national duty on the part of Zambians. Together we can make this country safer. Together we can achieve the aspirations of the nation.
We may allow the minister to wind up the press briefing. Honorable Minister.
Thank you so much. As usual, colleagues, I would like to thank you most sincerely. It has been a long night. All of you have been getting reports of the activities. At least for now, we have allayed the fears of those who have been saying that J.J. Banda is no more. He's alive, he's under our care, and we ensure that he's safe. Thank you so much.